Elbląg. Elbląg, Old Prussian, Elbings, is a city in northern Poland on the eastern edge of the Zyloy region with 121,191 inhabitants, December 31, 2016. It is the capital of Elbląg County and has been assigned, since 1999, to the Warmian-Masurian Voivodeship. Previously it was the capital of Elbląg Voivodeship 1975-1998, and a county seat within Gdańsk Voivodeship, 1945-1975. Elbląg is one of the oldest cities in the province. Its history dates back to 1237, when the Teutonic Order constructed their fortified stronghold on the banks of a nearby river. The castle subsequently served as the official seat of the Teutonic Order Masters. Elbląg became part of the Hanseatic League, which contributed much to the city's wealth. Through the Hanse Agreement, the city was linked to other major ports like Danzig, Gdansk, Lubeck and Amsterdam. After the defeat of the Teutonic Knights at the Battle of Grunwald and conclusion of the Second Peace of Thorn in 1466, the city was annexed by Poland. It then flourished and turned into a significant trading point, but its growth was eventually hindered by the Second Northern War and the Swedish Deluge. The city was transferred to Prussia after the first partition of Poland in 1772. Its trading role greatly weakened, until the era of industrialization, which occurred in the 19th century. It was then that the famous Elbląg Canal was commissioned. After World War II, the city again became part of Poland. The war casualties were catastrophic, especially the severe destruction of the Old Town District, one of the grandest and most beautiful in East Prussia. Today, Elbląg has over 121,000 inhabitants and is a vibrant city with an attractive tourist base. It serves as an academic and financial center, and among its numerous historic monuments is the Market Gate from 1309 and St. Nicholas Cathedral. Elbląg is also renowned for its archaeological sites, museums and the largest brewery in the country. The Elbląg Canal is believed to be one of the most important monuments related to the history of engineering and has been named one of the Seven Wonders of Poland. The canal was also named one of Poland's official National Historic Monuments, Pomnik Historii, in 2011. Its listing is maintained by the National Heritage Board of Poland. Elbląg derives from the earlier German language Elbing, which is the name by which the Teutonic Knights knew both the river here and the citadel they established on its banks in 1237. The purpose of the citadel was to prevent the old Prussian settlement of Truso from being reoccupied, the German crusaders being at war with the pagan Prussians. The citadel was named after the river, itself of uncertain etymology. One traditional etymology connects it to the name of the Helvecani, a Germanic tribe mentioned in ancient Greek and Latin sources, but the etymology or language of the tribal name remains unknown. The oldest known mention of the river or town Elbląg is in the Formulfing in the report of a sailor Wolf Stand from the end of the 9th century, in which was written in Anglo-Saxon in King Alfred's reign. Elbląg was almost completely destroyed at the end of World War II. The city became the Polish Elbląg after the war, when the area was ceded to Poland under border changes promulgated at the Potsdam Conference. Parts of the inner city were gradually rebuilt, and around 2000 rebuilding was begun in a style emulating previous architecture, in many cases over the same foundations and utilizing old bricks and portions of the same walls. The western suburbs of the old city have not been reconstructed. The modern city adjoins about half the length of the river between Lake Drusno and Elbląg Bay, Zatika Elblaska, an arm of the Vistula Lagoon, and spreads out on both banks, though mainly on the eastern side. To the east is the Elbląg Upland, Wysoczyzna Elblaska, a dome pushed up by glacial compression, 390 kilometers in diameter and high at its greatest elevation. It gives the appearance of ridges and parkland. Views to the west show flat fields extending to the horizon. This part of the Vistula Delta, Zuloy Wislain, is used mainly for agricultural purposes. To the south are the marshes and swamps of Drusno. The Elbląg River has been left in a more natural state through the city, but elsewhere it is a controlled channel with branches. One of them, the Jagiellonski Channel, Kanał Jagielloński, leads to the Nogat River, along which navigation to Gdańsk is common. The Elbląg Canal, Kanał Elblaski, connecting Lake Drusno with Drawica River and Lake Jeziorek, is a popular tourist site. Elbląg is not a deep-water port. The draft of vessels using its waterways must be no greater than by law. The turning area at Elbląg is diameter and a pilot is required for large vessels. Deep water vessels cannot maneuver. In that sense, Elbląg has become a subsidiary port of Gdańsk. Traffic of smaller vessels at Elbląg is within the river and very marginal, while larger vessels cannot reach the open Baltic Sea because the channel, once built in East Prussia to go through the peninsula, has belonged to Russia since 1945. The city features three key complexes, movable cranes, and railways. Elbląg is located about southeast of Gdańsk and southwest of Kaliningrad, Russia. The city is a port on the river Elbląg, which flows into the Vistula Lagoon about to the north, thus giving the city access to the Baltic Sea via the Russian-controlled Strait of Baltiisk. The old town is located on the river Elbląg, connecting Lake Drusno to the Vistula Lagoon, about from the lagoon and from Gdańsk. The settlement was first mentioned as Elfing in an Anglo-Saxon chronicle written in King Alfred's reign using information from a Viking who had visited the area. During the Middle Ages, the Viking settlement of Truso was located on Lake Drusno, near the current site of Elbląg in historical Pogzenia. The settlement burned down in the 10th century. Early in the 13th century, the Teutonic Knights conquered the region, built a castle, and founded Elbing on the lake, with a population mostly from Lübeck. Today the lake, now much smaller, no longer reaches the city. After the defeat of the Teutonic Knights and the destruction of the castle by the inhabitants, the city successively came under the sovereignty of the Polish Crown, 1466, the Kingdom of Prussia, 1772, and Germany, 1871. Elbląg was heavily damaged in World War II, and its German citizens were expelled upon the war's end. The city became part of Poland in 1945 and was repopulated with Polish citizens. The seaport of Truso was first mentioned ca. 890 by Wulfstan of Hedeby, an Anglo-Saxon sailor, traveling on the south coast of the Baltic Sea at the behest of King Alfred the Great of England. The exact location of Truso was not known for a long time, as the seashore has significantly changed, but most historians trace the settlement inside or near to modern Elbląg on Lake Drusno. Truso was located at territory already known to the Roman Empire and earlier. It was an important seaport serving the Vistula River Bay on the early medieval Baltic Sea trade routes, which led from Birka in the north to the island of Gotland and to Visby in the Baltic Sea. From there, traders continued further south to Carnuntum along the Amber Road. The ancient Amber Road led further southwest and southeast to the Black Sea and eventually to Asia. The east-west trade route went from Truso, along the Baltic Sea to Jutland, and from there inland by river to Hedeby, a large trading center in Jutland. The main goods of Truso were amber, furs, and slaves. Archaeological finds in 1897 and diggings in the 1920s placed Truso at Gutthansdorf. A large burial field was also found at Elbląg. Recent Polish diggings have found burned beams and ashes and thousand-year-old artifacts in an area of about 20 hectares. Many of these artifacts are now displayed at the Museum W. Elbląg. Attempts to conquer Prussian land began in 997. When Boleslav I the Brave, at the urging of the Pope, sent a contingent of soldiers and a missionary, Adalbert of Prague, to the pagan Prussians, a non-Slavic people, on a crusade of conquest and conversion. The crusade encompassed much of the Baltic Sea coast, including Danzig, present-day Gdansk, and other areas of the coast up to Sambia. Starting in 1209, additional crusades were called for by Conrad of Masovia, who mainly sought to conquer Prussian territory, rather than actually convert the indigenous Prussians. Despite heroic efforts, old Prussian sovereignty would eventually collapse after a succession of wars instigated by Pope Honorius III and his frequent calls for crusade. Before the Prussians and their neighbors to the west, the Pomeranians, were finally brought to heel, Polish rulers and the Duchy of Masovia, both by then Christianized peoples, would be continually frustrated in their attempts at northern expansion. Aside from minor border raids, major campaigns against the Prussians would be launched in 1219, 1220, and 1222. After a particularly sound defeat by Prussian forces in 1223, Polish forces in Chełmno, the seat of Christian of Oliwa and the Duchy of Masovia, were forced onto the defensive. In 1226, Duke Conrad I of Masovia summoned the Teutonic Knights for assistance. By 1230, they had secured Chełmno, Kulm, and begun claiming conquered territories for themselves under the authority of the Holy Roman Empire, although these claims were rejected by the Poles, whose ambition had been to conquer Prussia all along. The Teutonic Order's strategy was to move down the Vistula and secure the delta, establishing a barrier between the Prussians and Danzig. The victorious Teutonic Knights built a castle at Elbląg. The Chronik Interi Prussia describes the conflict in the vicinity of Lake Drusen, now Drusno, shortly before the founding of Elbing. Truso did not disappear suddenly to be replaced with the citadel and town of Elbing during the Prussian Crusade. It had already burned down in the 10th century, with the population dispersed in the area. The Chronik Interi Prussia describes the founding of Elbing under the leadership of Hermann Bock. After building two ships, the Pilgrim, and the Verdelant, Friedland, with the assistance of Margrave Henry III of Margraviate of Meissen, the Teutonic Knights used them to clear the Vistula Lagoon, Frisch's Half, and the Vistula Spit of Prussians. Apparently the river was in Pomazania, which the Knights had just finished clearing, but the bay was in Pogzania. The first Elbing was placed in Pogzania. Both landings were amphibious operations conducted from the ships. The Chronicon relates that they were in use for many years and then were sunk in Lake Drusen. In 1238 the Dominican order was invited to build a monastery on a grant of land. Pomazania was not secured, however, and from 1240 to 1242 the order began building a brick castle on the south side of the settlement. It may be significant that Elbing's first industry was the same as Truso's had been, manufacture of amber and bone artifacts for export. In 1243 William of Modena created the Diocese of Pomazania and three others. They were at first only ideological constructs, but the tides of time turned them into reality in that same century. The foundation of Elbing was perhaps not the end of the old Prussian story in the region. In 1825 a manuscript listing a vocabulary of the Baltic Old Prussian language, named the Elbing Prussian Dictionary, or more commonly in English just Elbing Vocabulary, was found among some manuscripts from a merchant's house. It contained 802 words in a dialect now termed Pomazanian with their equivalents in an early form of German. The origin of the vocabulary remains unknown. Its format is like that of modern travel dictionaries, i.e., it may have been used by German speakers to communicate with Old Prussians, but the specific circumstances are only speculative. The manuscript became the Codex Numanianus. It disappeared after a British bombing raid destroyed the library at Elbing, but before then facsimiles had been made. The date of the MSS was estimated at ca. 1400, but it was a copy. There is no evidence concerning the provenance of the original, except that it must have been in Pomazanian. In 1246 the town was granted a constitution under Lübeck law, used in maritime circumstances, instead of Magdeburg rights common in other cities in Central Europe. This decision of the order was in keeping with its general strategy of espousing the trade association that in 1358 would become the Hanseatic League. The order seized on this association early and used it to establish bases throughout the Baltic. The order's involvement in the League was somewhat contradictory. In whatever cities they founded, the ultimate authority was the commander of the town, who kept office in the citadel, typically used as a prison. Lübeck law, on the other hand, provided for self-government of the town. Membership in the Hanseatic League meant having important trading contacts with England, Flanders, France, and the Netherlands. The city received numerous merchant privileges from the rulers of England, Poland, Pomerania, and the Teutonic Order. For instance, the privilege of the old town was upgraded in 1343, while in 1393 it was granted an imperium privilege for grains, metals, and forest products. Except for the citadel and churches, Elbing at the time was more of a small village by modern standards. Its area was. It featured a wharf, a marketplace and five streets, as well as a number of churches. The castle was completed in 1251. In 1288 fire destroyed the entire settlement except for the churches, which were of brick. A new circuit wall was started immediately. From 1315 to 1340 Elbląg was rebuilt. A separate settlement called New Town was founded ca. 1337 and received Lübeck rights in 1347. In 1349 the Black Death struck the town, toward the end of the European plague. After the population recovered it continued building up the city and in 1364 a crane was built for the port. The German language Elbinger Rechtsbuch, written in Elbing, Prussia documented among other laws for the first time Polish common law. The German language Polish laws are based on the Saxon Spiegel and were written down to aid the judges. It is thus the oldest source for documented Polish common law and is in Polish referred to as the Księga Elbląska, Book of Elbląg. It was written down in the second half of the 13th century. In 1440 several western and eastern Prussian towns formed the Prussian Confederation, which led the revolt of Prussia against the rule of the Teutonic Knights in 1454. For assistance against the order, The Confederation asked for help from King Casimir IV of Poland, Casimir's subsequent claiming of Prussia led to the 13 Years' War. After the section of Prussians and Polish victory over the Teutonic Order, the city became part of the autonomous province of Royal Prussia under the suzerainty of the Polish crown in the Second Peace of Thorn. The city was known to the Polish crown by its Polish name Elbląg. With the creation of the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth in 1569, the city was brought under direct control of the Polish crown. With the 16th-century Protestant Reformation, the burghers became Lutherans and the first Lutheran gymnasium was established in Elbląg in 1535. From 1579, Elbing/Elbląg had close trade relations with England, to which the city accorded free trade. English, Scottish, and Irish merchants settled in the city. They formed the Scottish Reformed Church of Elbląg and became Elbing citizens, aiding Lutheran Sweden in the 30 Years' War. The rivalry of nearby Danzig interrupted trading links several times. By 1618, Elbląg had left the Hanseatic League owing to its close business dealings with England. Famous inhabitants of the city at that time included native sons Hans von Bodeck and Samuel Hartleb. During the 30 Years' War, Swedish Chancellor Axel Oxenstierna brought the Moravian Brethren refugee John Amos Comenius to Elbląg for 6 years, 1642-1648. In 1642, Johann Stobaus, who composed with Johann Eckard, published the Preußische Festlieder, a number of evangelical Prussian songs. In 1646, the city recorder Daniel Borholz noted that the city council employed Bernstein Dreher, or paternostermaker, licensed and gilded amber craftsmen who worked on prayer beads, rosaries, and many other items made of amber. Members of the Borholz family became mayors and councillors. During the 30 Years' War, the Vistula Lagoon was the main southern Baltic base of King Gustavus Adolphus of Sweden, who was hailed as the protector of the Protestants. By 1660, the Vistula Lagoon had gone to Elector Frederick William of Brandenburg, Prussia, but was returned in 1700. The poet Christian Wernicke was born in 1661 in Elbing, while Gottfried Eichenwald became famous for his teachings in natural law and human rights law. In 1700-1710 it was occupied by Swedish troops. In 1709 it was besieged, taken by storm on February 2, 1710 by Russian troops with support of Prussian artillery. The city was handed over to Polish King Augustus II in 1712. The imperial cartographer Johann Friedrich Andrisch completed a map of Warmia in 1755 and also made a copper etching of the galley named the City of Elbing. During the War of the Polish Succession in 1734, Elbing/Elbląg and Danzig were placed under military occupation by Russia and Saxony. The town came again under occupation by Russia from 1758 to 1762 during the Seven Years' War. During the first partition of Poland in 1772, resulting in the reunification of Prussia, the city-state was annexed by King Frederick the Great of the Kingdom of Prussia. Elbing became part of the new Prussian province of West Prussia in 1773. In the 1815 provincial reorganization following the Napoleonic Wars, Elbing and its hinterland were included within Regierungsbezirk Danzig in West Prussia. Elbing industrialized under the sovereignty of the Hohenzollern kings in Berlin. In 1828 the first steamship was built by Ignaz Grunau. In 1837 Ferdinand Schickau started the Schickau Werke Company in Elbing as well as another shipyard in Danzig. Later on, Schickau constructed the Borussia, the first screw vessel in Germany. Schickau Werke built hydraulic machinery, ships, steam engines, and torpedoes. After the inauguration of the railway to Königsberg in 1853, Elbing's industry began to grow. Schickau worked together with his son-in-law Karl Hsees, who continued the industrial complex after Schickau's death. Schickau erected large complexes for his many thousands of workers. Georg Steenk, an engineer from Königsberg, connected Elbing near the Baltic Sea with the southern part of Prussia by building the Oberlandischer Kanal, Elbląg Canal. Elbing became part of the Prussian-led German Empire in 1871 during the unification of Germany. As Elbing became an industrial city, the Social Democratic Party of Germany, SPD, frequently received the majority of votes. In the 1912 Reichstag elections, the SPD received 51% of the vote. After World War I, most of West Prussia became part of the Second Polish Republic. Elbing was joined to German East Prussia, and was separated from Weimar Germany by the Polish Corridor. During the Nazi Germany era, 1933-1945, three subcamps of the Stutthof concentration camp were located near the town, Elbing, Elbing, Orgdaupthut, and Elbing, Skanau. These were closed and many of the German inhabitants of Elbing forced to flee as the Soviet Red Army approached the city toward the end of World War II, see Evacuation of East Prussia. Laid under siege since January 23, 1945, about 65% of the city infrastructure was destroyed, including most of the historical city center. The town was captured by the Soviet Red Army during the night of February 9/10, 1945. During the first days of the siege, most of the population of approximately 100,000 persons fled. After the end of war, in spring 1945, the region together with the town of Elbing became part of Poland as a result of the Potsdam Conference. Almost all Germans who remained or returned were expelled by the communist regime during the following months. The city was settled with Poles from the eastern borderlands, which were annexed by the Soviet Union. After the expulsion of most of the German population, the city was repopulated and given the Polish name Elbląg. Of the new inhabitants, 98% were Poles expelled from Polish areas annexed by the Soviet Union from central Poland. Parts of the damaged historical city center were completely demolished, with the bricks being used to rebuild Warsaw and Gdańsk. The communist authorities had originally planned that the old town, utterly destroyed during the fighting since January 23, 1945, would be built over with blocks of flats. However, economic difficulties thwarted this effort. Two churches were reconstructed and the remaining ruins of the old town were torn down in the 1960s. Along with Trzeci and Szczecin, Elbląg was the scene of rioting in the coastal cities in 1970. See also Polish 1970 protests. Since 1990, the German minority population has had a modest resurgence, with the Elbinger Deutschmeinderheit organization counting around 450 members in 2000. Restoration of the old town began after 1989. Since the beginning of the restoration, an extensive archaeological program has been carried out. Most of the city's heritage was destroyed during the construction of basements in the 19th century or during World War II, but the backyards and latrines off houses remain largely unchanged, and have provided information on the city's history. In some instances, private investors have incorporated parts of preserved stonework into new architecture. By 2006, approximately 75% of the old town had been reconstructed. The city museum presents many pieces of art and items of everyday use, including the only 15th century binoculars preserved in Europe. Elbląg is also home to the Elbląg Brewery, Poland's largest brewery, which belongs to the Żuławy Group. The history of the Elbląg brewing tradition dates back to 1309. When Teutonic master Siegfried von Leutwangen granted brewing privileges to the town of Elbing. The present brewery was founded in 1872 as Elbinger Aktien Brauerei. In the early 1900s, the brewery was the exclusive supplier of Pilsner beer to the court of German Emperor Wilhelm II. Until World War II, there were many Gothic, Renaissance and Baroque houses in Elbląg's old town. Some of them are reconstructed. Other preserved buildings are Members of Parliament. Same, elected from Elbląg constituency. Elbląg is twinned with. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.